here in my greenhouse, and I have a quick video for you to show you something that happens with my roses, and I want to tell you why it is that I see these fancy speckles and dots on this rose here, bright pink. And this is not a fancy new variety of rose. This is the result of an organism, a fungus, called Botrytis cinerea. And every one of those spots is a place where the fungus has dropped onto the petals of the plant and tried to germinate, and then the rose has tried to fight it off. It doesn't always win. Sometimes you end up with kind of a mushy mess. I'm going to show you one back here. Focus on that. And this rose has prematurely balled up and isn't going to open or do anything good for that matter, because the botrytis got a foothold and then started to rot the rose. It also can show up like this. And these ones are a little further along. And this might be kind of what you see when your roses rot anyway, but these happen prematurely because of botrytis. So let's talk about botrytis for a second, and is it something you should be concerned about? Well, the truth is, it's a natural organism that does an ecological function. Rot organisms are good for something. They actually break down organic matter and make it available for plants again in the soil. So it's not a bad guy. It just causes some problems on your roses. How serious is it? Well, on roses, it's only really a matter of the flowers. You may see, and I'll see on the stem on the far left here, you can see it actually progressed onto the stem a little bit. It's got a bit of fuzzy matter there, but it's primarily a thing of the flower, and it's going to cause you some cosmetic problems, but it isn't going to compromise the health of your plant overall. How can you prevent it? How can you stop it? Well, let's rule out fungicides straight away as something that just isn't practical for this widespread of an organism. It just isn't something that you can maintain an environment free of botrytis, nor kind of would you want to in a way. The other thing you can do is you can try to control moisture, and that's probably the best way to attack it. In a greenhouse like this, I can control overhead watering, so I have a choice then to water a little bit less, and maybe I'll have a little bit less of the botrytis problem. However, out in the field, you don't get that much control over rain. So if you're in a wet climate like mine, you probably will have some problems with botrytis, and the only thing you can do then is go ahead and prematurely deadhead them to get that botrytis off, and hopefully the subsequent roses will be just fine. You can also do a little bit of pruning to try to ensure good air movement around the rose, but as I say, it's the kind of thing that if you live in a wet climate like mine, you probably just live with, you look at, you're interested in, but you can't do that much about. All right, thanks for watching.